Welcome back to Whiteface Mountain, everyone. We're near Lake Placid, New York, on a sunny and chilly afternoon here in the Adirondack Mountains. Perfect day for snow sports. Sandy Caligiuri here at the bottom of Draper's Drop once again, and we're ready to bring you the first half of the women's combined. It's the Super G on the combination of trails, Thruway, and Draper's Drop that saw Fabiana Dorigo capture the Super G gold medal yesterday. Well, she's back in action today, along with the others that were on the podium with her, Celia Abad from Spain and Carmen Sophie Nielsen from Norway. So as exciting as it was in the morning when Jan Zabestran was the, let's say the first half leader capturing the Alpine combined Super G, we'll see if Dorigo can maintain pace and do the same. And we're just moments away, really, from the start of competition. Air temperature at the start, it is minus 12 and a half Celsius. Here at the finish, it is 9. We have lots of sun here in the North Country of New York State today. Take a look at the combination of Thruway and Draper's Drop. The length is 1,200 meters. It has a vertical drop of 360 meters. The course setter, John Norton, once again, who's handled those chores for the Super G skiing. Start list here for the first half of the combined, the women's Super G. Michelle Herney will lead us off. And you see some of the medal winners coming up, Fabiana Dorigo, Nielsen, Abad. They took the hardware yesterday, celebrated last night at the medal ceremony on Main Street in Lake Placid. We've got a field of 34 skiers. Michelle Herney, 19 years of age. She's from the ski club Matten. 10th yesterday in the Super G, and she gets us underway. Ernie looking good on that top section. Now trying to carry the speed into the flatter part of the course. Tight aerodynamic position, very key in this section. Try to get the skis running as much as possible between some of those gates. Now on to Draper's Drop. Named after the first mountain manager. Oh, hang on there, a little bit wide. And she made it, but that little jump there, about four gates up from the bottom, has proven to be problematic for some in the morning. As we go to the German, Leonie Anna Flotgen, 22 years of age. She was fifth yesterday. So you can anticipate she is going to compete here in the Super G, part of the combined. Representing the ski club from Starnberg in Germany. She has 6 podium results in 5 races. Half of them, by the way, victories. So when she gets in the hunt, she knows how to close it. Two seconds behind at the intermediate point. So not the desired result that Flotkin was looking for after yesterday's race. And now we see that she's gone into the lead. With Axel Chevrier now on course. She's from La Plagne in France. That's the former Olympic site. Did not finish yesterday. So now with better visibility, a good start number, she hopes to make good, and she is. A quarter of a second ahead on the upper part of this combination, Thruway and Draper's Drop. In her career, she's had 23 podium finishes in FIS races, and among them have been 10 wins. Here's Axel Chevrier. Her time into the lead by over 3/10 of a second. Chevrier in 50.44. Well done. Now from Ukraine, one of the two Shepelenko sisters. This is Anastasia. And she's got a very high benchmark here to try to surpass. But again, with good visibility, good start position, it's possible. 1700s behind at the timer. Coming in from behind on the gate, try to complete the turn above it as best they can. Anastasia Shepelenko, 3/10 off the lead. And now into the final pitch and the finish for Shepelenko, about 3/10 behind. Chevrier stays in the lead. So our next skier is Domenica Mosca from Switzerland. Axel Chevrier of France has the early lead at this point. Seven tenths off. Can chip away at it with some good skiing the rest of the way. .37.77 at the midpoint. Final few gates. Domenica Mosca, 12th yesterday in the Super J, Super G, and she is fifth in this run to this point. From Spain, Celia Abad, the bronze medal winner yesterday. And she, see if she brings that good fortune to Whiteface Mountain today. .2 behind. See if she chips away at it. Abad is 1100s to the good, so she has done more than chip away at it. She has now grabbed the lead, but let's see from that timing point to the finish if she can hold on to it. She crosses, yes, and she adds to it, one of the very few we've seen in the past couple of days to make time from the second timing point to the finish, and she goes to the lead. As we look at Norway's Carmen Sophie Nielsen, the silver medal winner in the Super G. This is another excellent top section we're seeing. Nielsen is slightly ahead. So everybody will be paying attention to this. She looks loose, relaxed. It's kind of letting the skis and the legs just kind of float with the terrain. Here she comes. Is Abad's time in trouble? Let's see. Oh no, she lost some time. But again, this is something we've seen over a couple of days. Losing time from the second timer down to the finish. And now as we look up at the top of the course, as we move into the afternoon hours, a little bit of shade coming in. Not as bright as it was this morning. But these skiers will move out of that and get into the mostly sunnier conditions. From France, Louison Acambray, ninth yesterday from the ski club La Clusaz. She won the 2022 French national title in giant slalom in Tignes. So she has technical skills too to go along with her ability at speed. 9/10 out. Here comes Acambray, a 21-year-old, all the way through in 51.10 and about 9/10 of a second from Abad. Abad, Chevrier, Nielsen, they're in the leader's box, and that's how it will be overnight. Abad and Nielsen were medalists yesterday, and now we've got one of these Shepelenko sisters in fourth place, Anastasia. We will not have yesterday's gold medalist, Fabiana Dorigo. She lost a pole coming out of the start, and just a couple of gates later, day was done. Well, after an exciting finish to the men's combined earlier, we've now returned to Whiteface Mountain for the conclusion of the women's combined event. Hello, everyone. This is Sandy Caligiuri once again with you on a comfortably cool afternoon here in the Adirondacks. The Super G portion of this event was held yesterday with Celia Abad of Spain racing into first place. And after Alberto Ortega took the gold medal this morning, Abad will try to complete a sweep of today's World University Games titles for her country. It's a tight one though. The top six right now are separated by just 3/4 of a second. The top eight are in the same second. As we take a look at the start, a little cloud cover has moved in, but no harm, no foul. It's still excellent conditions. As we take a look at the air temperature, the snow temperature, temperature here is in the 20s. This course, different of course than the men's slalom. It's a different set. There are some rhythm changes in it, which we will show you as we begin the coverage. It's a field of 29, and so the format will be from 29 down to 1. We'll build up the excitement and build up the audience engagement, if you will, and bring this to a climax at the end. As we bring Julia Soquet d'Agereau onto the course from France and the ski club at Saint-Gervais. Earlier this month, she had a collection of top 10 results in FIS races, including a third in Solda. Okay, you come off that side slope, then into a couple of open turns, and then there's a little flush there waiting for you, but she's negotiated all of that. And she's 7/10 up. That's how good she negotiated it. That's outstanding. From France, Louis Saint-Encambray. From the ski club La Clusaz. As we get down to the final racers in the 29 skier field. She had a first and a second in fifth races in December in Valois and Puy Saint-Vincent. Top of Draper's drop here. 21 years of age. Encambray was ninth in Super G. So she's got a good result under her belt. And she had a good race in the combined Super G. Encambray skiing well. 6 tenths behind. She goes to second place.
43.23, so that'll slide for Leone Flotigan. Flotigan from Germany now.
Now Leone Anna Flotigan. Fifth in Super G, an excellent result 2 days ago on a difficult Super G course. Note the rhythm change there. Longer radius turns into a tight flush there and then into the hairpin. Now it widens out again with the side slope. And pretty soon after this wider turn, they'll get to a little flush, the hairpin. Yeah, they're being challenged, there's no question, especially late in the run when maybe the legs are starting to feel some burn. And she's less than half a second back. She goes into second place.
0.05 for the German. That'll slide Maureen Larch.
From Ukraine, Anastasia Shepelenko. This is the sister of Katerina. She's raced some World Cup this season for the first time. She's been on two World Championship teams. Looks like she's having a calculated slalom run here. You probably received some radio reports on what some of the problem areas are. She has 6 top 20s in fifth technical events this season, including a second. Shepelenko to the finish. 1.5 seconds almost behind.
It looked like she had some difficulty. She got in the back seat. She had to recover and scrape some speed to do that. Still a good run from
Shepelenko. And the top three, though, remain unchanged, at least at that point.
Still to come. It's
the States rounding out the top five. We're down to the final three, as we call it, the sharp end of the field. Carmen Sophie Nielsen from the University of Alaska Anchorage. In her freshman year, she won the silver medal in the Super G. Now a little tight section there. Then it opens up a little. And now entering Draper's drop. Finishing the turn above the gate, not below the gate. That's an optimal tactic. Nielsen, she's 8 tenths behind, fifth place. Axel Chevrier, and then the leader, Celia Abad. Chevrier of France. Hopes to use that 84 hundredths of a second advantage. can see some of these rhythm changes that we've been referring to during this run. Some of the turns are longer radius, and some come at you very quickly, especially when you get into some of the flushes. Chevrier from La Plagne. She's exhibiting some pretty good skiing, I must say. And Chevrier is a second behind. So now there's only one skier left that can upset this apple cart, and that is Spain's Celia Abad, our last skier of the day. She had a bronze medal in the Super G. You see her advantage, just over a second. Will she take a seat in that leader's box? Will she join Albert Ortega and make it a doubleheader sweep for Spain? Abad ahead by 8/10 of a second. Right now, she's on her way. Top of Draper's drop. On the side hill, didn't seem to present much of a problem. Through that last flush, couple of final gates, that's all she needs for a gold medal and a sweep for Spain. Abad wins it by nearly half a second. A terrific performance by Celia Abad. Here are your medalists. Celia Abad with the gold. Dagere of France. The silver, Floetgen of Germany, takes the bronze.
Finishing in third place, from Germany, put your hands together for Leonie Floetgen. Finishing in second place, let's hear it for Julia Soquette Daguerreau from the French delegation. And now in first place, and the women's Alpine combined champion representing Spain, put your hands together for Celia Abad. The Lake Placid 2023 FISU World University Games winners, ladies and gentlemen. Let's give them a hand.
There is the final result. Abad, Daguerreau, Floetgen, the medal winners here at Whiteface Mountain.